Mr. Vice Chairman, sir, the compulsory deposit scheme which was introduced in 1974 was partially withdrawn in 2007 for the lower income group, and it has continued for income groups having an income of rupees 15,000 and above per year. Sir, the objective of the bill is laudable as being anti-inflationary and to save what is called conspicuous consumption, but is the government really serious about the whole matter? Sir, it has been reported in the press that the government wants to impound 50% of the dearness allowance due to the central government implies. Why has this dearness allowance become due? It became due from the month of March and May this year because the average 12 monthly index crossed 400 and 408 respectively. Not only that, last month a third installment has become due because the industrial consumer price index has gone up to 453. All this is because the government policy about controlling the prices has been a complete failure. Without controlling the price line, the government will not be able to achieve anything. It will help neither the country nor the poorer sections of the people. I think this government has not decided what should be its price policy. The price policy has to be integrated with the policy relating to incomes and wages, and unless this policy is settled by the government, it is no use having only the compulsory deposit scheme against those who are regular monthly salaried workers or those of higher income groups. But even though they may be of higher income groups, with the high escalation of costs and the index going up so steeply, their purchasing power is already eroded. Therefore, I would like to know from the government what steps it is going to take for the stabilization of cost of living, which has to be the main objective of any economic policy. Sir, stabilization of cost of living has been given a go by. Nothing has been done to control the prices. On the other hand, black market and a parallel economy are flourishing. Prices of ordinary vegetables like the cauliflower are rupees 20 per kilo and tomatoes are selling at rupees 28 per kilo. Everything has become so costly. Still, the government wants to attack those people who are only wage earners and whose incomes are fixed. There is a fear that with the financial accounting year coming to a close, the bonus question will come up, and this government, which has no order policy except to finance the workers and its employees, will come forward with a sort of an ordinance or a bill by which they will deprive the workers of their bonus, or they may ask them to deposit it with the government. As I said earlier, this government must decide about its policy. The government must come out with a decision to have a national pay policy for all the government servants, including those of the state governments, and therefore it is very essential that a national pay commission should be appointed to decide the policy so that the working classes and employees can cooperate in the economic development of the country. I find that the government is not taking any steps to prevent black marketing or to run the public distribution system effectively. Hardly 4 lakh public distribution shops have been opened. As against the total population and the working class population, it is a very meagre number. Therefore, the worst affected persons due to the rising prices are the poor people, the toiling masses, and the entire working class. Therefore, sir, my submission is that instead of continuing such schemes and having only piecemeal legislations, will the government decide a price policy or stabilization of the cost of living, which is very essential to have more economic development and prosperity. If they really want the employees to be partners in industry, the government must accept in principle that the fruits of prosperity must be shared by the working classes, and therefore the time has come when participation of labor in management has got great importance. Otherwise, we are caught in such a vicious circle that no progress can be made. What is happening now is the rich are becoming richer and all the black marketeers are having a field day. We have heard of the prices of land in Bombay and other things and how everything is being exploited by the big businessmen, smugglers and others who are having a field day in the country. Therefore, I am opposed to this type of ordinances. Sir, the government has adopted a noble method for solving the economic problems of our country. When the budget was presented, they did not spell out the terms. In fact, a bill with the necessary fiscal measures should have been thought of when the budget was presented, but in the budget session, nothing was done. Recently, the prices of petrol and other petroleum products were increased without any indication in the budget.